At a nearby conservation lab, I meet with research archaeologist Dr. Bob Bayer.
Bob.
Josh.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
Working with documents from my man in Havana, John DeBry, Bob has found a literal smoking gun that may pinpoint another lost ship from the treasure fleet.
Well, you got a gun on the table. That's a dangerous start to an interview.
Yes, it is.
What is this?
This is a flintlock pistol and firing mechanism, and this was found at Melbourne Beach.
So when these items were first found, did people think this was part of the 1715 fleet, or they didn't know?
People didn't know because this site is 16 miles north of the 1715 fleet wreck.
Right, so like the other site I looked at, this is really kind of what was thought to be kind of outside the beltway of where these boats would have wrecked.
This was thought to be separate.
So it may be that parts of this fleet truly are farther north than people had thought before.
That's my belief, Josh, yes.
And the pistol isn't the only stunning find recovered from the Melbourne Beach wreck site. Divers also uncovered cannonballs and two ornate silver platters.
And so what do we know about these artifacts? Can we tie them to the time period?
On the firing mechanism, there's the inscription, 1709.
Oh, look at that right there.
And the maker's name, Ramirez. He was a noted Mexico City gunmaker.
And we can see his name is right there, Ramirez.
Wow. Is there any way to tie them, though, to the fleet?
Yes, we can, if we look at the two silver platters.
Okay.
Inscribed on the rim of the silver platters is a name, Donna Juana Isabel de los Monteros.
How do we tie that to the fleet?
A document has been found in Spain that lists the silver platters as being consigned to the Concepcion.
And the Concepcion is one of the ships from the 1715 fleet.
It is definitely one of the ships, Josh.
This is a major breakthrough. For the first time ever, an artifact can be definitively linked to a specific vessel from the fleet. And according to the records discovered in the archives, the Concepcion was the Admiral's flagship, carrying a haul worth hundreds of millions today.
So you think there's a lot more down there to be found?
The treasure is undoubtedly still out there.
To date, only a handful of artifacts have been recovered from the site. But right now, Seafarer Exploration, a team of professional explorers specializing in underwater conservation and recovery, is closing in on the remains of the ship. I race to catch a ride out to their research vessel, anchored about a quarter mile off Melbourne Beach.
Is this us?
This is us, the Iron Maiden.
Rock and roll boat.
The Maiden is moored over a large object it picked up on sonar that may be part of the wreck of the Concepcion. I come aboard to meet salvage expert and dive master, Aaron Cartwright.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, good to see you.
Good to see you too. So tell me about the Iron Maiden. What is this vessel all about?
We outfitted this boat for research and salvage and put these blowers on it.
Yeah, let's talk about these. This is not something that you normally see on the back of a boat. What are these?
So this entire thing pivots down and goes under the boat. You put it in gear and it deflects the prop wash through the tube and out the end here, which is facing down, and just blasts the sand off the bottom floor.
So this is like the ocean's version of a giant leaf blower.
Absolutely, yes.
Cool.
The technique removes the top layer of sand, allowing underwater archaeologists to study the strata below. The technique was pioneered by treasure hunting legends Mel Fisher and Kip Wagner, but the seafarers have dialed the Maiden's blowers up to 11, using twin 350 horsepower engines.
Are we anchored over your site right now?
Yes, we're on the site right now.
This
we're actually
it.
Over a target right here.
Do you think this is the Concepcion? Do you think this is one of the ships from the 1715 fleet?
We gotta get in there and find out.
All right, well, show me what's down there.
Okay.
Let's do it. Come on.
While the Seafarer team has found scattered artifacts linked to the Concepcion, the actual ship itself is MIA. Aaron believes the wreck could lie just below us, so we gear up to dive.
Go ahead.
We splash in, and Seafarer project manager George Gruber lowers one of the blowers. He'll be on standby to activate it once we've located the target.
I'm good. You ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, head it down. Here we go.
Visibility is going to get worse as we go down. Stay close to that rope.
With the assistance of a sea scooter, we drop down more than 30 feet.
Okay, Josh, start scanning around this area.
You got it.
Each sweep of the metal detector sends up a cloud of sediment, completely obscuring our surroundings. Now that we've located a target, it's time for the Iron Maiden to rock.
Diver to topside. Go ahead and fire it up.
We're gonna start blowing at 500 RPMs.
All right, Josh. Hang on. It's gonna blow this whole area out. Be careful.
Copy that.
Prop wash is coming down.
Oh, there it is! Oh my God, it just cleared everything out! Look at that! It's literally just dusting off the entire seafloor! Oh my word! Look at that! That's wood! Did we just find the ship? I mean, look at this!
That's wood!
This timber may be a historic find. Part of the Concepcion rediscovered after 300 years. And it looks like more of the wreck is buried beneath the sand.
Josh, to topside! Keep hitting it with that blower!
Increasing to 600 RPMs. We're at 600 now.
Oh my word, look at this!
This is a huge piece of timber.
With the sand cleared away, we can see the extent of this piece of wreckage, spanning more than 20 feet across. It looks like it could have been part of a deck or hull, and it certainly seems big enough to have come from a 100-foot-long galleon like the Concepcion.
What is this? Is this metal?
That's definitely iron.
What do you think this is, a pin of some kind?
Absolutely. It could be a deck pin, it could be a keel pin. There's a million pins on these ships.
Unbelievable!
Now, we've got one of them.
We continue to examine the timber, unearthing more fittings, indicating that this was part of a ship from the 1700s.
Something along the side here.
It looks like a piece of iron.
Got a hole in it. Look at that.
That could be a deadeye. They used to run the lines through this.
You think that this is from the fleet?
Yes.
That is so cool. Every time you dust the bottom, it's like a piece from a jigsaw puzzle. This is history right here, right in front of us! We could be looking at a piece of the Concepcion! Nice work, man! This is incredible!
This is the first time remains associated with a specific ship from the 1715 fleet have ever been identified. We continue to comb the bottom, looking for more pieces of the Concepcion and her precious cargo. Whatever is here is deeper and will need to be excavated carefully over time.
Okay, air's running low. You ready to head up?
Okay, let's go to the surface.
Josh for Iron Maiden, we are coming up.
We return to the boat, a step closer to one of the greatest treasure troves on Earth.
Okay. Unbelievable.
Yeah, what'd you think?
You got a ship down there, that's what I think.
Yeah, we do.
These other 1715 wrecks, they found artifacts, but you don't find really much of the ship.
That mud down there really preserves it well. Covers it up and seals it like a time capsule.
It's mind-blowing.
A lot more to uncover. You just gotta keep working and dig it out.
Today, we may have made history, discovering wreckage that could be from La Concepcion, a flagship from the 1715 fleet. And we may be just a few feet away from another monumental find. Hundreds of millions in Spanish gold, silver, and jewels, recovered after more than three centuries.